all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here. Friends, hope 2024 is treating you well so far. It's been good so far for me, and I'm looking forward to the rest of the year. And today, as promised, we're going to talk about ASC22 from Aceltis. We are specifically going to talk about a combination of ASC22 with Chidamide to fight HIV. This combination, according to Aceltis, could be a functional cure for HIV. I've covered this therapy earlier, and this is a revision and may contain additional information developed since then. Let's get started. Welcome back, friends. Well, Aceltis has positioned ASC22 as a potential functional cure for HIV and chronic hepatitis B. There are two sets of trials taking place right now, and the first one has progressed to phase 3, and it is for using ASC22 for hepatitis B. And the second set of trials is in phase 2 and studies ASC22 with chidamide to provide a functional cure for HIV. In our video today, we are focused on ASC22 with chidamide. Aceltis envisions ASC22 as a functional cure. When they talk about a functional cure for HIV, they are talking about achieving a means of controlling the virus to a level where it doesn't cause harm, even if complete elimination of the virus is not possible. So it's in contrast to sterilizing cure. In a sterilizing cure, all the viral copies in the body is totally eliminated, so the patient is totally free of the virus. Whereas in case of a functional cure, the virus is under total control. There'll be trace amounts of virus in the patient's body, but that cannot be removed. And it doesn't allow those viruses to continue propagating and damaging the patient. So that's the positive aspect of functional cure. The first patient dosing of ASC22 in combination with antiretroviral therapy for HIV has been done, marking a significant step in the development process. So that happened somewhere in the middle of 2022. And now we're going to talk about what ASC22 is. ASC22 is a single domain antibody against PD-L1. PD-L1 is programmed death ligand 1. It's a pathway often targeted in oncology for cancer treatments. However, this antibody is not limited to cancer. It also addresses HIV and HBV. HBV stands for hepatitis B virus. By blocking PD-L1/PD-L1 pathway, that is, by blocking attachment of PD-L1 to PD-1, the pathway is destroyed. So there is no binding of PD-1 to PD-L1. By doing this, ASC22 restores the human immune system's ability to recognize and eliminate HIV or HBV infected cells. This includes potentially reversing HIV latency. So when ASC22 was administered in clinical trials, it has the advantage of being administered via subcutaneous injection rather than doing a drip, and it has provided convenience over other intravenous methods. The drug boasts a favorable safety profile and exhibits good stability at room temperature, contributing to its practicality and ease of use. It has been reported as well-tolerated in chronic hepatitis B patients. And in order to understand how ASC22 works, we need to understand CD4 T-cell mechanisms. CD4 T-cells have surface protein called PD-L1. When PD-L1 on infected cells binds to PD-1 on T-cells, it sends inhibitory signals to the T-cells. The T-cells can be activated CD8 plus T-cells or activated CD4 plus T-cells. This interaction suppresses the activity of the CD8 and CD4 T-cells and prevents them from mounting a robust response against the infected cells. By using the PD-L1/PD-1 interactions, HIV-infected cells can avoid being targeted and destroyed by the human immune system, allowing the virus to persist within the host. This immune evasion strategy poses challenges for the immune system and complicates the treatment efforts, as the virus can hide within the cells, avoiding detection and clearance. ASC22 has a competitive affinity to PD-L1 and binds quickly to PD-L1. PD-L1 is expressed only on the surface of infected CD4 T cells. Once ASC22 binds to these cells, then healthy CD4 T cells will be able to avoid being inhibited and will destroy the infected CD4 T cells, With that, the HIV inside the destroyed cell will also be gone. That's how you destroy the entire factory which keeps on manufacturing HIV virions and putting it into the blood. Now, what do you do about the dormant or latent HIV? This is where chidamide comes in. Chidamide plays a crucial role in disrupting HIV latency. It mainly targets specific subtypes of histone deacetylases addressing epigenetic abnormalities. Now, that's a mouthful. I wanted to go read and understand this whole thing, but I think it's going to take me another few weeks of reading to get to the bottom of that. But suffice to say that the data suggests that chidamide has the potential to disrupt HIV latency, which is a significant obstacle in HIV eradication. So you have this kick and kill or shock and kill kind of strategy where chidamide can shock latent HIV to start getting active. And when it becomes active, it can immediately be seen by the CD4 T cells. And before the CD4 T cells are calmed down by the PD-L1 and PD-1 binding, we have ASC22 coming in between and preventing a binding of the PD-1 and PD-L1. And therefore, the cytokine release is possible for these CD8 plus or CD4 plus activated T cells, and they go and kill the HIV infected cells. That's how the whole thing works. This comprehensive approach of combining ASC22 and chidamide showcases a promising strategy for addressing the challenges posed by HIV and chronic hepatitis B. The focus on disrupting HIV latency is particularly noteworthy in the quest for effective treatments. Now let us look at the clinical trial records to see if there have been any updates since the last time we made a video on this therapy. So let's go to the clinicaltrials.gov website. Well, friends, here we are at the website of clinicaltrials.gov. And what you need is this particular number out here, which is a clinicaltrials.gov ID. It is NCT05129189. Just pause the screen, write down this number, go to clinicaltrials.gov, search for it, and you'll come to the page that I am on. And this talks briefly about the summary. It's exactly the same thing that I explained to you. And it shows that the study actually started on 29th of June, 2022. And the primary completion date was 30th of July, 2023. And we don't have anything else posted. It says no results posted. So that's all we have out here. This is, Aceltis is being operated from Shanghai, China. And we have to wait for results coming from them in order to understand what is happening. So next I thought that let's go and have a look at the website of Aceltis and see if they have any information on ASC22 with chidamide. Here we are on the website of ASC22, and we are under the viral diseases. And in the viral diseases section, there is only one entry, and that entry is for HBV. It doesn't talk about ASC22 with chidamide. And in fact, there is only one mention of HIV out here. No, there is not even a single mention of HIV out here. So what it shows here is something that we can take for HIV also. It says anti-PD-1, which goes and latches onto the PD-1 receptor, as a result of which the CD4 T cell is not able to latch onto the PD-1 on the HBV-infected cell, as a result of which this T cell is not going to be inhibited. It's going to release cytokines and kill this HBV-infected cell. So that's how it's going to work. So this is what we have here. And I was looking at the other area as well where I went into their clinical trials section, because in products they don't have it. I went into clinical trials one, and in clinical trials one, in page one, I couldn't find an entry. So I went into page two, and in page two, I was able to find an entry of study to evaluate safety, tolerance, and efficacy of ASC22 combined with ART in subjects with HIV. Now, this doesn't talk about chidamide either, but it talks about... And what I found was this particular entry. So we have 143. So this is the record that I got once I went into clinicaltrials.gov and put the clinical trials ID. And what it says here is just ART. It doesn't talk about chidamide. So we don't have any information formal information on how ASC22 works with chidamide. And this particular trial started on 20th June 2022, and it was completed on 6th December 2023. We don't have the information other than the fact that it did not create any problems in the body. So we have another press release here, which came around 24th of July 2023 from Acelltis itself, where they are saying that the phase 2 study showed that combination treatment with ASC22 and chidamide is well tolerated and effectively activated latent HIV reservoirs. There was significant increase in CAHIV RNA at week 8 and week 12 compared to the baseline, with an average rise of 4.27-fold and 3.41-fold respectively in subjects. The HIV CARNA to total DNA ratios also showed the same trend. P is equal to 0.038, P is equal to 0.017 respectively. Further investigations are warranted. So basically what I take from here is that it was well tolerated, but what I don't get is a statement that says that CD4 T cells were able to go and kill the infected cells. That information is not available here. So we'll have to wait for more details, and then we'll be able to get some conclusion around this. And friends, this is the problem that I face when I'm dealing with a non-US company, because the US companies have got a standard approach of how they present the information to the shareholders, and it's easy to get the relevant information from the website itself and also by doing Google search. But in this particular case, right, we don't have all the information that we need. This is all I got. I'll continue searching. If I get anything more, I'll bring it to you. And friends, with this, I'd like to bring this video to an end. I'll catch up with you again in the next video. Bye for now.